So my name is Patrick Beukema. I'm a graduate student researcher in the Center for Neuroscience at the University of Pittsburgh. I study motor learning in general, how we learn to perform exquisitely precise movements, what parts of the brain are involved in that process. For example, shooting a free throw or playing the piano. All of these are really relatively complex movements from the standpoint of neuroscience. And so I study how the brain changes in order to facilitate the acquisition of these complex skills. My mother is a physician, she's an anesthesiologist, and she loved it. She would do medical missions. She would talk to me about how young kids would have cleft lip or cleft palate, and she would do the surgeries for them. So that was, I think, my motivation initially to get interested in biomedical research to begin with, or medicine in general. And then sort of the logical next step for me was to go into science research. I think what got me into science initially and why I've stayed in science is it's really sort of where I think a lot of the discoveries happen that end up, you know, helping people. What's really fascinating to me is how much of our brain is dedicated to motor learning. I think we're more used to thinking of the brain as able to solve these complex cognitive problems. Like, for example, a game of chess. That's like a very difficult game to learn and to become skilled at, but just moving the pieces on the chessboard also takes enormous training. It's just that we're so good at it, we don't consider that this difficult problem that we need to overcome. We just sort of automatically learn from when we're children how to, you know, move efficiently in the world. We've solved the problem of chess from an algorithmic standpoint. We can design computer programs to beat the best, you know, chess player currently in the world, but we can't, or we have much more difficulty designing robots to move the pieces on a chessboard. And if you think about the hierarchy of learning, you might expect that, you know, the actual game would be more difficult to solve than just moving the pieces on the board, you know, physically moving the pieces. But in fact, we've had more difficulty with the latter problem, which is very interesting because that means that motor processes, motor learning, skill acquisition is an extremely complicated problem that the brain solves. And a lot of the neurons in your brain are dedicated to making expert movements. And if we want to understand and help design treatments and cures for people who suffer from motor disorders like Parkinson's or Huntington's, then we better understand, you know, how the brain learns to make complex movements in the first place. I think the bottom line is when you think about the brain, it's hard not to be interested in the brain, right? Because it's how we experience the world. And yet once you start getting into the neuroscience, you know, getting into the study, you realize we really have very limited understanding of a lot of complex phenomena. And that's like kind of shocking, you know, like we experience the world as just a series of electrical impulses. That's every single experience you've ever had. It's just a population of neurons firing, which is kind of mind-boggling when you think about it. You know, you think you're experiencing the world in real time, but you're not. You know, you're experiencing in the past, and it's just the result of electrical activity in your brain. And the most fun aspects of being an academic or of being a scientific researcher is the joy of discovering something that no one has ever seen before or no one knew.
This definitely makes sense. Yeah. Showing one match of 10. Oh, you just
but
control.
But being at the forefront, at, you know, truly like the cutting edge of what we know about how the brain works, I think is one of the most pleasurable aspects of being an academic and being a scientist. You're surrounded by tons of really creative, really intelligent people.
C is the catch trial.
Who are basically sort of united in a common goal. And so that makes for really exciting conversations. I mean, I'm surrounded by a great team here in my lab. And I think one aspect of science that might be sort of missed in the media is that big discoveries and, you know, big innovation is the result of like massive team efforts. When you study science, you learn to look at the world in a different way, you know, in a very rigorous, analytical, but also creative way. in addition to all the career prospects you'll have and the exciting jobs that you'll have after you graduate, you'll have a perspective of the world that is really unique and priceless, you know, in terms of appreciating, you know, the wonder sort of that is our natural world and the human brain in my case. And I just think that that's priceless, I guess.